online class. So I said I've incorporated those into the service reflection papers. Let's look at exam. So the exam is due October 24. Assignments. Okay. So here it is. You're hired as a new manager and you're given the material of the ladder of inference because the business you are managing is having some difficulties with interpersonal difficulties between employees and guests and employees and fellow employees, and therefore sometimes not meeting the expectations of their guests and consumers. First, summarize the ladder of inference to your employee using the job that you pick as your context. So whatever you choose that you're a manager in, summarize the ladder of inference. Therefore, hotel, restaurant, call center, etc. Secondly, personalize the assignment and share with the employees your personal walk and journey with the ladder of inference, showing how you used it to improve the areas of advocacy, inquiry, and reflection in preventing or solving service dilemmas. If you want to go in some way modify or use your examples from the service reflection paper, you can. I was very lazy, and when I identified that assignment, I liked to use it for other things. So you can use some of those examples or you can create new ones. It's just up to you. So secondly, talk about your walk. And then third, in the employee meeting or training that you have on the ladder of inference, come up with an activity that you will do with the employees to demonstrate and help them understand and improve themselves using the ladder of inference. They will have 30 minutes for their activity, and then you will bring them back together for a debriefing. So what I want you to do, and I said using between 1,000 and 1,250 words, I think so far one of our best service reflections was a chart on advocacy, inquiry, and reflection. So I don't necessarily want an essay of just words. I want you to show me that you understand the content. And since I asked for a training module, you could design the handout that you give to the employees as that part of the exam, because that's something you could use for the future. So for the exam rubric, the summary of the ladder inference and the accuracy and completeness, 33 points. Assessment of your experience with the ladder and your current assessment, 33 points. And then your employee workshop team activity and your closure on the employee training, 34 points. So you have until October 24th, and I said between 1,000 and 1,250 words, that's 4 pages on the ladder of inference. Usually you, in the class, I had you do something like that inside the class time in pencil. So this time I'm just switching it up. So you can still have more time to work in your teams on your movie and video and let you do the essay at home. Any questions on that? Before we talk about our team meetings.
Yes, I have a question. The second
one. Oh, thank you. I love that. So you like details too. Mm-hmm. It's not just the journal. I wonder when you in my office, I have these pictures and I have them hanging like this. Like it's all about sideways. I wonder if you like that or not. But it's symmetrical. There's 4 pictures hanging sideways. Like Marilyn Monroe and Einstein. And Marilyn's face is going down and Einstein's going up. It wouldn't work. You would want to fix them.
Yeah, like collages.
Uh-huh.
I'm like straight corner.
Oh, you want it neat. Absolutely. I understand. There's some brilliance in that. Yesterday I was talking to an artist and she said, I said, tell me about your work. Well, she had this, I would have bought it, but I wasn't paying $1,800 for it yet, until my book sales. It was a dragonfly, and she made it from a collage of all her pictures of colors she made, and then she just cut out the giant dragonfly, and she framed it in all white, and it was a giant dragonfly cut out of pictures she had made. And so I said, I like the mixed media you use in your work. Tell me how that evolved. And she said, it started when I was a painter, and every teacher told me, don't follow attention to such details. And she said, I ignore every one of them because the details, that's what keeps me happy. So she said, I sort of evolved into this work, and she had gotten one of the Best of Show awards. So any questions on that? Yes.
Yeah, so it's a hypothetical scenario, I guess, that is...
Yes, which that, you know, if you worked in the same industry for 10 years, that's easy for you to do. If you don't have a lot of experience in an industry, you can make your context up. Just tell us this is based on the context of. Yes. Yes. Yes.
And then, so the example that you would be explaining to this employee, that you are made up or
your history, yes. For I don't think it works to make one up. It should be real. It should be real because real is, I think, real is more important when it comes to those things. It's hard to make them up, and it's more memorable to you if it's real. Any questions on that?